Hey guys, welcome back to another YouTube video. This is third video of graphical user interface development or a GUI development in Python. So in previous videos we have seen lots of things about the Kintel library, and in last video we have seen some kind of function like a geometry function, title, max size, mean size and many more functions. And we have also seen about the geometry managers, that is a pack, place and grid. So basically in this video we are going to move ahead and we are going to learn about some kind of attributes, okay, attributes of the label and attributes of the geometry manager, that is a pack. So first here I am going to run our code, and here you can see that here we are getting a GUI. Size of that GUI is a 720x480, and inside that GUI you can see that we are getting our label, that is a hello, this is my first GUI. So basically here we imported all the classes from the Kintel library. After that we created one object of the TK class, okay, and after that you can see that we created, we have used a geometry function, title, max size, mean size and many more, okay. So whenever we create a label, and after that we are going to use attributes of that label, because whenever we create any type of label, after that attributes are used to decorate that type of label, okay. So there are lots of attributes available in our Kintel library. Here we are going to learn some of them. First attribute that we are going to talk about is background, okay, label background. Now bg, you can call it as a bg background. So you can change the background of any color as you want. So right now you can see that we are getting our label as a string, that is a hello, this is my first GUI, and you can see that there is a no color right now, okay. Now I am going to add color in our label. So bg is equal to, so basically you can pass any color as you want as a string, okay. You don't need to pass any type of RGB value and all that things, okay. You can simply pass as a string. So here I am going to pass as a purple, okay, and now I am going to run this code. So here you can see that here we are getting our label with purple background, okay. So you can change the color as you want. So let's say here I am going to do red, and you can see that this is a red color. Let's say here I am going to change as a white. You can see that this is a white color, okay. So here I am going to set as a purple. So you can use any color as you want, okay. There are lots of colors available in our Kintel library. Now let's talk about the second attributes of the label. So basically second attribute is a font color, okay. So you can change the font color as well. So right now you can see that our font color is black. So you can see that inside our GUI that our font is black right now. So here we are going to change font color of our label. So you have to just say FG, okay, font ground, and inside that you can pass any color as you want. So let's say here I am going to pass, let's say red color as our font. You can see that here we are getting our label with red font color, okay. So but you can see that red color is not looking pretty much good. So here I am going to set as a white. Now you can see that this is looking good, okay. So basically you can use any color as you want, okay. So you can use any favorite color as you want. Now let's talk about the third attribute. So in our Kintel library you can use any font as you want. You can download any font from the internet, and after that you can install that font in your device, and after that you can use those kind of font inside your Kintel library, okay. So here I am going to say font is equal to, one thing is that you can pass font as a tuple or you can pass font as a string as you want. You can do anything as you want, okay. So here I am going to pass font as a tuple. So I am going to make one tuple. Inside that I am going to pass a name of font as a string. So here I am going to pass area, okay. So inside our tuple, first parameter will be name of our font. The second parameter will be size of our font. So here I am going to set size, let's say 25, okay. And the third parameter, if you want to set your font as a bold, so you can enable bold, and if you don't want to set bold, so you don't need to pass third argument. Okay, so here I'm going to pass bold. Now here I'm going to run this code. Now here you can see that here we are getting our GUI, and inside our GUI you can see that we are getting a purple color background, a white font, and you can see that the font is now changed, and you can see that the size of font also increased now. Okay, so you can see that there are lots of fonts available. You can change any font as you want. You have to just pass out that name of that font as a string. Okay, so this is a basic attribute you can use anytime. Now let's talk about the another attribute. So whenever you create, so now I want to show you one thing. So here you can see that in our GUI you can see those borders. Okay, so you can see that those borders. Now now whenever we wanna decorate those type of borders, so that time we are going to use relief. So in our Kintel library they provide us one attribute that is a relief. Okay, so you can, there are five types of reliefs available in our Kintel library. You can use that, and after that you can decorate your border of your label. Okay, so here you can see that there are basically five type of border styles available in our Kintel library. So let's use our first one. So one thing you have to notice that you don't need to pass border style as a string. You have to just pass as a keyword. Okay, so first one is this one. Okay, now I am going to run this. Now you can see that here we are getting our border style, our different border style, but you are not seeing that much correct, because okay, so first I am going to change the border width. After that you can see that. Now the another attribute that is a border, so you can change the border. So here I'm going to set, let's say 20, and now you can see that here we are getting a border decoration, okay, with 20 size of our border. Let's say here I'm going to do 10. Okay, now it is good. So this is a first style of a border decoration. Okay, now let's use another one that is a race. So you can see that this is a second border decorating style. Okay, so you can play around all these things. So let's check our third style, that is a groove. So you can see that groove is looking great. Okay, so you can change if you want. Let's say use this flat. So basically flat means no border, like a flat. Okay, so you can see that is a flat. Okay, let's use the last one and the fifth one, that is a ridge, and you can see that this is our last border. So basically there are five types of border decoration available. You can choose any of one. So basically I prefer this first one. Okay, and this first one and this third one, because I love that most. So you can choose anything as you want. Okay, so let's talk about another attribute. So basically we have seen about the background color attribute, we have seen about the font color attribute, we have seen font attribute. Inside that you can pass a font, any font as you want, and the size of your font and bold. Okay, and we have also seen about the border style, border decorating style, and the last attribute that we have seen, that is a border, size of your border. So you can change any size as you want. So here I'm going to hit 12. Okay, so we are going to move ahead, and we are going to learn about another label attributes. So you can also pass a padding in our label. So what is a padding? So basically padding means extra space. Okay, so now you can see that here inside our GUI you can see that our label is placed as a center. Okay, so let's say here I'm going to pass padding. So here I'm going to set pad y is equal to 20. Okay, let's say you can see that is our padding. padding. Now you can see that is a pad y is equal to 20. Let's say here I'm going to say pad y is equal to 50. And now you can see that is the extra spaces between your text and borders. Okay. Now let's talk about the pad x. So basically there are two type of paddings. One padding for x direction and one padding for y direction. So let's say 50. And you can see that is a pad x and pad y. Okay, so you can play around with all these things. So now we are going to move ahead and we are going to look at the attributes of the geometry manager. Okay. So basically we have seen all the important attributes of the label, and we are going to now we are going to look at the attributes of the pack. Okay, so pack, we all know that the pack is our geometry manager. Basically there are three type of geometry managers available in our Kintel library. First one is a pack, second one is a place, and third one is a grid. So basically we are going to talk about grid and place after few videos. Okay, so basically we are going to use pack and grid mostly. Okay, if you want to use place, so you can use that. Okay, so basically in place you have to pass a coordinates. Now we are going to learn about the pack attributes. Okay, so first attribute that we are going to learn is that anchor. Okay, so anchor meaning is that basically you have to pass the position of your label, okay, as a direction. You can pass as a direction like a north, east and all that things. Okay, so first I'm going to copy this and paste this here. Now so you have to pass anchor or position as a string. Okay, so first position that we are going to pass as a north. So N means north. Now you can see that we are getting as a north. So basically by default set as a north. Okay, if I change it as a east, now you can see the changes. Okay, I can also do south, east, south, south, west and all that things. Okay, let's talk about the second attribute, that is a side. Side. So basically there are four sides. First one is a left, right, top and bottom. You can call it as a up and down. Okay, so here I am going to copy this and paste this here. So basically in anchor you can pass north, north, east, east, south, east, south, south, west, west, north, west or a center. Okay, so here I am going to talk about this side. So first I am going to set side as a, let's say bottom. Okay, bottom means down. And now you can see that we are getting our label on a bottom side. Okay, north, east, bottom side, east, bottom side. Okay, now let's talk about the second one, that is a left. Can see that we are getting as a on the left side. If I do top, you can see that. Okay, and if I do right, okay, so let's talk about the another attribute, that is a fill. So what is a fill? Basically fill means that you can increase the size of your GUI. Okay, so first I'm going to show you, after that I will explain you about the fill. Okay, so first I have to comment down this and let's talk about the fill is equal to x. Okay, fill is equal to x. Now I'm going to set side as a, let's say bottom. Okay, and now I am going to increase the size of our GUI. Okay, so you can see that our label size also increased now on a x direction. You can see that. Okay, if I don't pass fill, then you can see that the size is not increased now okay, size is not increasing. So basically fill is used for create one attractive GUI, okay. So fill is equal to, let's talk about the fill is equal to y, and I am going to set side is equal to left. Okay, I have to pass y as a capital Y, okay. And now I am going to increase the size of our GUI, and you can see that the size of label also increased now, okay. If I say, let's say, okay, so basically you can pass anchor. So basically you can use side, you can use fill, you can use anchor, anything as you want, okay. So we have seen lots of attributes, we have seen about the label attribute, and we have seen about, we have seen lots of pack attributes, okay. So guys, that's it for this video. If you have any comment, any question about the attributes of the label, and if you have any question about the attributes of the pack, so you can just ask me in comment section below. Thanks for watching this video.